What happened, Priya?
I had a dream about nail polish, makeup and fancy clothes, and I really wish I could have those and know these things.
Why are you so shocked? It is just a chemical engineering application, and being a chemical engineer, you must be aware of it.
What are you talking about? Is this as simple as you're saying it is?
Yes, of course it is. It is just a fundamental application of what we have studied up till now.
Oh, that sounds compelling. Can you enlighten me on these fundamentals? I am really fascinated by glitters and their use.
So basically, it is an application of non-Newtonian fluids. In these type of fluids, the viscosity alters on applying force. The harder you hit the fluid, the more viscous it becomes.
Some common examples of non-Newtonian fluids which are used in our daily life are honey, blood, toothpaste, paint and shampoo. Now let us know some behavior of these type of fluids. Like number one is dilatants. A dilatant material is one in which viscosity increases with the rate of shear strain. Shear strain occurs when a sideways force is exerted on any medium. Like we are applying this force on a book. So this is the shear strain which is developed on this book. Now second behavior is oobleck. Oobleck is a non-toxic economic example of a non-Newtonian fluid. Oobleck has some unusual behavior. One example is that if a person punches it or any impact is applied to it, it acts like a solid. But when a gradual load is applied to it, it tends to act like a liquid. Now second behavior is rheopectic. Let us understand it with the example of a cream. The longer we stir the cream or whip with the cream, the thicker it gets. This is rheopectic. Another behavior is thixotropic. The common example of a thixotropic fluid is honey. With constant stirring, solid honey becomes liquid. Means these type of fluids viscosity increases with stress over time. We will be manufacturing the edible glitters today. So let's start the manufacturing process.
In a pan, take cornstarch of 1 tablespoon. Then pour 1 cup of water in that pan. Cook cornstarch in medium flame. Continuously stir and cook 5 to 6 minutes. Cook until mixture turns glossy and slightly thick. Mixture begins to dry from the side of the pan. Then add food coloring agent to give it some fancy color. Mix it well. Put that colored mixture on the sheet and let it dry. Dried sheet of corn starch shines from the other side. Separate it from the sheet and grind it. Then sieve the mixture to get the fine particles. Now you will get the homemade edible glitters.
So thank you very much for your time and patience for watching this video presented by AICHE RJPT student chapter.